Hello there for the second season of Theodoblique's tutorial episode 3. And today we are flying an agility 19 square meters. And with this agility we are going to try rhythmic, anti-rhythmic, infinite, all the fun stuff everyone wants to do when they start to be acro pilot. I mean, if you start acro and don't want to do infinite, it's a strange way to do it. So that's what we are going to do today. We will first start with the rhythmic and anti-rhythmic timings and stuff before in next episode going into tumbling, infinity exit, all these other matters. So right now we are going with the rhythmic. For the rhythmic, what we are going to do is we are going to enter into a SAT, and as soon as we enter the SAT we will release and pull again pretty hard and pretty soon. It means that we will have full energy on the first turn of the rhythmic. Okay, so basically when do we pull during a rhythmic? Basically it's pretty easy. You pull after you passed over the glider. And I don't say when you pass, I say after you pass. It's really important because if you pull when you pass, the glider tends to collapse, which I will show you later. While if you pull after you pass, the glider keeps full energy. And there is like a lot of signs, you know, that shows you that your glider is, you are pulling maybe too early or too late. For example, the first sign when you pull too early is the outside tends to collapse, you know, slight, light collapse and bigger collapse if you pull really too early. And these signs get heavier every time you go higher. When you get into infinite and pull too early, the collapse is bigger and it tends to stop you infinite. I mean, it's not really nice. So really you have to pull even later than too early is better. Okay? So at the really beginning of the rhythmic, what we will do is enter the SAT, release as soon as we enter and pull really hard. But you don't release all the way, you keep just a little bit of break on the first turn, you know, it's really just this turn you keep a little bit of break, and afterwards you release full on. Okay, so remember, you pull after you pass the glider and you release all the way to the top, no brakes, because if you keep brakes the glider will have tendency to collapse. Outside brake is always on top, no brake on the outside. It's also really important. Weight shift, I think it's better to stay neutral. If you put some weight shift with nowadays glider, it's not necessary really. You can put some inside weight shift to go faster, but really with a glider nowadays it's not necessary, and that's things you will have to find about your glider, what she prefers and stuff later on. So when we will exit our rhythmic, first I will not climb to the really top to show you that even if you don't climb to the top, you can just release, wait for the glider to come down. Sometimes it's a bit messy, but the anti-rhythmic will always bring you down. I mean, come on, it's super easy. It will always work out. So you will see. I will do this first rhythmic without going all the way up. And then I will do a second one going all the way to the infinite and going down really fast to the anti-rhythmic again. And then we will do a third one staying in the infinite and giving you a few tips about it. So on the first rhythmic I will not go to the top, so I will do, let's say, the first three or four bumps, and I will pull on the, so I will enter the SAT, release, pull really hard. I won't release on the first turn all the way up, but on the turns after I will release all the way up. So I will pull the SAT, release as soon as I enter, not all the way up, pull again pretty hard, and then release all the way up and really wait to pull. I will wait to pull and gain elevation like this. So I will wait, pull, and you release when the glider wants to shoot. So I will pull when after I pass the glider and release when the glider wants to shoot. Okay, I will say it all the way. First I will enter the SAT, so ends up there. Okay, I enter the SAT.
I pulled and really
okay? So I pull after I pass, it's really important. Right now I will do exactly the same, but this time I will go to the infinite. Okay, what's happening when you go to the infinite, full infinite? As much as you climb, the timing is more and more important because every mistake will cost you dearly. When you do a mistake in rhythmic, the glider tends to collapse, and because you are over the glider, you lose energy, and when you lose this energy, that's where you have risk of falling into the glider and all this kind of scary shit. So that's not what we want to happen to you. At least I don't want this to happen to you. Maybe the other people, but me, no, it's okay. So what I will do is I will start to pull hard at the beginning, because the first turn you need to pull hard. If you don't pull hard, the glider won't go up. And as much as I climb, I will pull a bit less, you know, the brake, because if I pull a lot and I make a mistake, the mistake will be even worse. So what I will do is pull less. If you pull more, the glider will go up faster, you will win time in the rhythmic, but then you will have more risk to do a mistake or anything. And that's not what we want to do. You will do this after, when you have mastered the rhythmic and everything. So okay, I will go. And let's go. Always wait the last turn to do something in anti-rhythmic. If you don't wait the last turn, you have risk of pulling too early and getting a collapse. That's not what we want to do again. So we have just arrived to Infinity Tumbling. Congratulations, guys. You've managed it. Huh? Come on, don't show off about it. It's pretty easy. Really, really easy. So we were in Infinite. We were vertical. We were enjoying the turns and everything. But the glider, you have to wait for the glider to come down, and sometimes it takes some turns, and turns means altitude. And so it's better to train rhythmic really when you have some altitude. I mean, in a place like Organia, like where we are now, or Lago di Garda, or any place with a lot of altitude, because if you are coming down in anti-rhythmic, it will take altitude. And this is really bad when you are in a place with no altitude, because sometimes you can end up a lot lower than you thought you were. So please guys, train with altitude this trick, particularly if you come down with anti-rhythmic, which is the safe way to do it actually. Sometimes it's possible that you think you are in infinite, but you are not yet there. It's like, there is the shape, everything looks like infinite, but in fact, no, you are like really close, but not yet there. So as soon as you release, you will feel the glider will come down, one side or the other one. Then it means you are not in infinite. That's also one of the signs. What to do in this case? Either you try to pull it back to the infinite, take your time, late rhythm, low pull, don't pull too hard, really take your time. If you miss one pull, it's okay, don't worry. Just grab the risers, wait for it, you will come down in anti-rhythmic easily. As soon as you have any doubt, go for the anti-rhythmic, don't worry, it will save your ass. That's for sure. So right now we are going to do another rhythmic, this time build it up to infinite again. But I will stop slightly before the infinite. So you will see the glider will want to come down because I'm not yet there, I'm not yet in infinite. And I will try to put it back in infinite by small pulling, trying to be in the timing, trying to understand. You will see it's working really good, it's also a really good training. And then I will put it to the other side, and then to the other side I will try to pull it back again to the infinite. You will see it's really easy. But you have to be able to do it both sides. It's important because otherwise you won't be able to put back the glider in infinite when you need to. It will be, it's messy, come on. It's really important that you do this. So I will go for this rhythmic again. And I will stop just before getting vertical, then build it up vertical again, then pull it to the other side, then pull it vertical again, and then come down in anti-rhythmic easily. There I go. Okay. have just done this last rhythmic for today's episode. Have you seen it's fairly easy to go to this infinite? It's not a hard trick, and everyone can do it pretty easily. Just remember that when you get vertical, take your time. If you miss one turn, it's okay, no problem. Nobody will say anything to you. Remember that when you get vertical, you have to pull really slower than before. You know, you have to pull like a bit later, release a bit earlier, and with like less strong pull, you have to be really like in a softer brake. Take your time. It's okay if it takes you 10 turns to go in infinite. It's your first rhythmic to infinite. Nobody will penalize you for this. In next week's episode, we are going to check out tumbling. So it's also an interesting stuff. Really interesting. And most importantly, we are going to check out infinite exit. I mean, this one is really important. If you are training, for example, in a place like Organia, you are really high. Don't try rhythmic in your home spot where you have 400 meters if you don't know how to exit your infinite, because if you exit an anti-rhythmic, it may take some altitude you don't have. So please really take care you don't master infinite before being able to exit it. You can't show off to anybody saying I'm doing infinite if you are not able to exit. So please wait that you learn to exit before showing off. And this will be in next week's episode.